Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines, a masterpiece or terribly broken? I'll leave that discussion to others, because we have some modding to do. In this video, we make this nearly 20-year-old game look a bit better. This small guide combines different mods that blend well together. It'll keep a Vanilla gameplay feel and it will be realistically playable. I'm saying realistically playable because Vampire Bloodlines is a very fragile game. You really can't go too overboard with retextures or big mods. Especially when upscaling or retexturing to higher resolution, the game can easily crash due to memory limitations even with a memory patch. If you don't own the game yet, I suggest getting it on GOG. I feel like it's a bit more stable overall. I playtested this guide fully on Steam because of the same reason. This guide should run on whatever platform. Of course, I left timestamps in the description and comment section to navigate more easily if you wish. For this video, however, I do advise to watch everything at least once, even if some parts do seem redundant to you. It's just so you know what to expect, what choices you want to go with, and if this guide is something for you. First, we take a look at the unofficial patch, which is more or less essential if you want to enjoy the game to its fullest potential, while still keeping a Vanilla gameplay feel. The unofficial patch fixes bugs and inconsistencies, updates the game itself with better memory handling, and makes some tweaks that arguably should have been in the game in the first place. The base patch is a must-have really for a multitude of reasons. Optionally, there is a plus version of the patch with more tweaks and content. The plus version adds an additional quest to the game and makes other small tweaks in existing quests. It even adds some Easter eggs and a way to bypass the infamous sewer levels, among some other shortcuts. I do recommend the plus patch on top of the base patch, even if you never played the game before. Of course, not having played the game before, you probably won't even notice what was added and what was not by the plus version, and because of that same reason, I see no reason not to use it. It's really just mostly add-ons to an already nice game. And if you do run into a shortcut or Easter eggs added by this mod, it'll be quite clear. You will have the option not to take that path or Easter egg. Now, many people advise against using this plus version if you never played the game before, so do make of it what you will and choose for yourself. If you run the game from GOG, the base patch has been implemented in the game. GOG users do still need to download the plus patch if they wish to use it. Install it on top of the implemented patch with the installer, and you can choose all options. Steam users download and run the unofficial patch. Even if you don't want to use the plus version, do install the other optional components. Direct the installer to your Vampire Bloodlines directory. Be sure to double check, since the installer sometimes assumes you have the game in program files for whatever reason. Once you're sure it is directed to your main Vampire Bloodlines directory, install it. It's also reported that copying steam.dll to your Vampire Bloodlines main directory can help solve some crashes. The file is located in the base folder of where you installed Steam. If you want to launch the game from Steam, you have to add this line in Steam launch options, like shown on screen. And if you also want the console to work and show up, you have to type console after it. If you still run the disk version of the game, you'll have to read the readme on the patch or do a quick Google search. I haven't tried it, but apparently you need to make the installer 64-bit first with the optional component from the unofficial patch. Once installed, and if you use widescreen, go to patch extras in your Vampire Bloodlines directory. Then go to player mods. Run the respatch.exe and select the main folder of Vampire Bloodlines. Here you can set your resolution and your field of view. I recommend a field of view between 70 and 80 for this game. Simply choose your aspect ratio and fill the choices for resolution. Click patch it and that's all. It should now be patched for widescreen use. You can check the other optional folders and read the readmes later, but I'm not including them in the video. It's not mandatory per se, and I myself don't use reshades or EMBs for reasons that I explain later. We then finally move to the first mod, Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines HD. This is a huge mod that upscales the textures of nearly everything in the game. This is downloaded from ModDB. Download all three parts. It is reported that this mod has an error in the installation process, which I can confirm since the same happened to me. So here are some special instructions to run the file properly, but if it ever gets solved or if you don't get the error, you can of course ignore these special instructions. First, extract the first folder. Don't drag and drop the folder, but extract it like I do in the video or directly from outside the file. When it's done, open part 2 and extract it the same way. you may now see an error on malk_cigar.ttz. Open the archive of Pack 1 again. Go to HD Textures, Models, Scenery, Structural, Malkavian, and right-click malk_cigar.ttz. Copy this inside your new unpacked folder at the same location. If you don't do this and you had the error before, the installer will fail. If it doesn't give the error or if it's fixed, you can ignore this instruction. Now, I would usually tell to make a backup of your original files by now, but it's up to you if you want to. Vampire Bloodlines itself is less than 3 GB in size, and setting it up to this point takes a matter of minutes, so I personally don't bother yet. Now run the installer of this mod and direct it to your unofficial patch folder, which is found inside the main Vampire Bloodlines directory. Installing this takes a while, so be patient. Be sure to turn off the volume that comes up halfway the installer, or you'll be up for a surprise if you cut your volume up. At this point, the author is just throwing us. The final step we have to take is open the Fix Crash on Loading folder that comes with these packs. Drag and drop it directly in your Vampire Bloodlines main directory, overwriting the file. The mod is now successfully installed. It's a nice mod that upscales textures, but its installation is a bit tedious if you run into the install problems. Now at this point it might be a good idea to make some backups for easy restoration after adding a mod if you want to. And also from here on, when installing a mod and there are overwrites, just overwrite all. One can use MiHealth Vampire Bloodlines HD pack from the Nexus on top of this. This has some additional retextures and redesigns, and for some parts it complements the previous mod. For this guide, however, we only use a few folders from this mod. The full mod includes many pornographic retextures for posters and magazines that in my opinion just look out of place. It's not how this guide was built, so we exclude all of the ones that look out of place. Using this full mod also adds additional strain to an already fragile game. Open the materials folder inside the mod and extract only the wood, brick and stone folder directly in your materials folder of the unofficial patch. Now open object folder and extract everything except the Fastgirl D files into your unofficial patch material object folder. Finally, go inside Models Scenery folder in both this mod and the unofficial patch, and now extract Street and Furniture to the unofficial patch. Now the only place you still encounter any nude-themed retextures are on videotape covers found inside the sin bin, and on a few trash cans and machines. I find that these aren't too much in your face or out of place for most of the places you still see it. As example, I think it's fine for the sin bin in particular to make use of these retextures. Even Vampire Bloodlines in Vanilla already had these in very low resolution. You can also use the NPCs that come with this mod. MiHealth's HD pack covers nearly all NPCs in-game. Using this, many iconic characters will completely change. Sometimes it even changes clothing styles, skin and hair color. I think it's a nice choice if you played the game before and want to go with something new completely. On top of that, it's also the most complete NPC retexture I came across.
Have you come for the kind of enlightenment only Jezebel can give?
Yeah, whenever you're done, sweet cheeks, we can move this show along.
If you wanted to use this, open the Models folder inside the Materials folder. Now open the Character folder and extract the Ice and NPC folder to the same file structure in your unofficial patch. Optionally, go all the way back to the root of the mod and extract the Models folder to the root of your unofficial patch. This retextures one of the models for prostitutes that are commonly found in downtown. Now, there are many mods that change the looks of NPCs. With any mod that retextures a multitude of NPCs, I advise to just use one mod and not just install the next one you come across on top of the previous one. If you want to be extremely thorough and picky, and if you know what you're doing, you can exclude a character from one mod and use files from another you like better instead. However, I think you can already tell that this would be a tedious process in testing and probably too much effort for most mod users. I'm just mentioning the possibilities here. There is a fairly new NPC retexture mod, which is NPCs Improved. This improves most of the NPC's faces, teeth, body and clothing. It's more in line with the Vanilla designs than what Mihal's HD has to offer. However, much like the previous mod, some characters do look better than others to me. Also be aware that this one has a lot fewer retextures for NPCs included than Mihal's. NPCs Improved goes really well together with another mod made by the same author. This retextures the eyes for NPC. If you opt for this mod instead of Mihal's NPCs, this goes in the same folders as before. Another large retexture you might come across is the HD ground work in progress. Again, I've tried different things with this. Most of this looks somewhat out of place in some locations with what we are going for, so I exclude nearly everything. Don't get me wrong though, on its own this mod does look good, but also very clean. For the best result with this mod list, you can download the second file only. Extract only the carpet folder directly inside your materials folder from the unofficial patch. We now take a look at our own character. One can use Player Character Improved, which upskills your own playable character. I suggest to just download the file of the clan and gender you want to play with. Also, if you want to use specific reskins for your character, you don't need this. Simply extract this to your unofficial patch folder. If you search around, there are many more skins for your own character and the different armors that come with it. Retextures of existing skins work the same as before, you can simply replace the existing files. There are completely new skins to be found, which are handled a little bit different. As example, we take a look at custom PC skins, which I've been using in this video. The files are installed the same way as before, but you can notice the custom PC folder if you look at the folder structure. This means that the skin is placed separately from the main game files in its own folder. The game doesn't read the files on default, so you have to edit something first. Open your unofficial patch, like before, and locate VData. Then go to System. Now open clandoc000.txt. What you do is find your female vampire clan like shown in the video. You now replace the name of the clan with custom PC. If you do it like this, the game reads the files from this folder instead. And if you do understand this process, you could even use the same method on other existing reskins made by others. Just restructure the folder and text files with the same name, so the game reads that location instead. Now there are two mods to choose from that change and add many posters, pictures, billboards, it changes some HUD elements and other similar things in the game. Both of these have similar features, so choose which one you like the best, if any at all. I recently stumbled upon modernized HUD and billboards. These retextures magazines, billboards, advertisements, etc. with similar references that fit better in 2021. I guess people that like the metal genre in music can appreciate some of these changed posters. The mod also simplifies the HUD elements. While the original HUD of the game does look good, I think this one is a little bit less intrusive. A similar and more popular mod that adds many new things to see in the game is the Time 20 mod. This basic file retextures many of the posters, bus stops, billboards, and everything in that category. It retextures these to fit the World of Darkness theme better. Like the author suggests, even if a player isn't a World of Darkness fan, or doesn't even know what it is, perhaps these references might inspire them to investigate a little bit further. The plus file of this mod also alters a few emails, PC documents, and adds a handful of Easter eggs to the game, referencing popular people that contributed to the game and modding scene. It does a bit more than just retexturing, so I advise to read the readme if you want to use it or not. Now the plus version is a nice extra, but I didn't test it with this mod loadout, and it might add some additional strain to an already fragile game. So be advised if you want to use the plus version on top of the basic version. Again, these files go directly inside your unofficial patch directory. Before you do so, I recommend to remove the main menu folder before you extract it. Doing this will keep the main menu title to its HD original that was added by the first mod. If you just want the Vanilla main menu title screen, you can delete the main menu files directly from inside your unofficial patch. Very optionally, one could try and add reshade or EMB presets to the game. At some places it admittedly looks great, but at other places just not so much in my opinion. My biggest gripe with them is the inevitable performance loss and some locations being either overly dark or too bright. There are many, however, and I guess it's something for some players, or else there wouldn't be so many. I personally play without them though. Reshades and EMBs are placed in your main directory of Vampire Bloodlines, so not in your unofficial patch like the other mods before. There are many great mods that actually add to the game with additional content or change the gameplay drastically. The very best mods for this game are often hosted on ModDB. This guide was aimed to keep the gameplay mostly vanilla, so I didn't exclude them. Nor do I think it's realistic to add more strain to the game with this mod list. The plus patch of the unofficial patch already makes the most mandatory tweaks needed to enjoy the game even more than its vanilla state. I did play many of these complete overhauls, and my favorite is most likely Clan Quest mod, which is also one of the more popular ones. Who knows, I might showcase a few of these complete overhauls sometimes. This guide might not be a large list, but like I said, a modded Vampire Bloodlines can't handle that much, and this should already make for a really decent improvement. Without the unofficial patch that makes the game large address aware, this wouldn't be possible at all. One could even say this list already goes pretty overboard. If you decide to use even more, I can nearly guarantee there will be a persistent crash at some point while transferring areas. I'm also not gonna bring you under the illusion that using this guide will be completely crash free. I had 12 crashes in this playthrough, where I tested nearly every quest available. Okay, maybe not this one. All my crashes happened when transferring from area to area, especially traveling from downtown Santa Monica. I just recommend saving before taking the cap. It'll crash, you reload, take the cap again, and it takes an extra minute. Really though, even with just the unofficial patch installed and no mods at all, the game does crash once in every blue moon. And the Steam version seemingly more so than GOG. If you do disregard my advice and want to add more from within this list or outside of this list, you can try of course, it's your game. As long as they are retextures only, and if you make backups, there's a good chance you can roll back without many issues. I love Vampire Bloodlines a lot. By all means, this was really just a mod list focused on making the game look a bit better. I hope I gave some decent recommendations though, and that you learned something new in the process. Graphics aren't usually my focus, it's often the last thing I judge a game by. There are so many good-looking games that just try to hide a mediocre gameplay experience. One can season the poo-poo, but I doubt it will be much better experience when digging into it. I really hope Vampire Bloodlines 2 gets it right. The recent reports and developments didn't help with expectations I have for this game, but let's hope I can prove future me wrong. Anyway, thanks for watching guys, have a good night and don't let the vampires bite.
A tuna walks into a sushi restaurant, says to the chef, "Hey, you killed my father." Chef says to the tuna, "That's my business, fish." Tuna thinks about it, says, "Then I challenge you to a game of chess. If I win, you stop being a chef forever. And if I win," asks the chef, "you can feed me to your customers," tuna replies. So the chef and tuna play chess. Tunas love to play chess, so in a few moves, the chef was checkmated. "Well, looks like I win," says the tuna. Chef nods and plunges his knife into the fish's belly. "But I won," says the tuna, as he feels the knife wiggling into his guts. "So did your father," says the chef.
What were we laughing about?
I am the proprietor and salesman of the month several years in a row. The ladies call me,
oh God!
But you can call me Fat Larry with a F-A-T, cause I know I got a weight problem and I just don't give a fuck.
A massive explosion rocks Santa Monica tonight, sending several fireballs into the sky and prompting a lockdown of the warehouse district where the explosion took place. Early reports suggest that the warehouse destroyed in the explosion was being used in a weapon smuggling operation, and that the source of the detonation possibly came from you.
Welcome to Sang's Herbal Remedies. I am Sang. How may I assist you?
Are you with immigration? Are you police?
Hold on, please. These are good remedies for many problems. No credit cards.
Several dead in a beach house in Santa Monica tonight. Police suspect the slayings were carried out during a drug deal gone bad. They suspect this may be the work of vampires and... Hey, have you seen any vampires around here?